Cam Newton is the football quarterback for the Carolina Panthers, and he's been vegan since February, seeing a sharp decline in his performance. With an underwhelming start in two games to begin the 2019 season, he now has a lingering left foot sprain that will cost him at least two more games. Even a strength and conditioning coach was onto something. Now, you take away the most valuable part of that diet, and there's just no way around it. He can't recover as well with less nutrients, with less calories, and with less muscle mass. It's just not going to happen. There are plenty of examples of other NFL players, Tony Gonzalez as well as Gerald McCoy, going vegan and losing size as well as strength. But as usual, the vegan mongoloid advice of not eating enough calories or protein remains the consistent message. They weren't doing the vegan diet properly. So why do vegan athletes see a sharp decrease in performance and almost immediate injury within months? First, we have to understand what muscle building is. Anabolism. Many of you might be familiar with gym bros drinking protein shakes right after their workout so they don't go catabolic, remaining in an anabolic metabolism. But anabolic pathways use ATP that is actually produced by catabolic pathways. These two catabolic pathways are the citric acid cycle, aka the Krebs cycle, and the urea cycle. A very simple explanation of why a vegan diet doesn't allow you to recover optimally or even perform optimally is because a plant-based diet does not provide the nutrients that your body requires to run these two processes in an optimal metabolic state. It's evident that there aren't any naturally muscular vegans. They all built up their muscle mass before following the diet, or they used a combination of steroids and artificial supplements to get where they are. Let's take a look at the anabolic pathways. Right off the bat, we see that a vegan diet would be lacking both fat and protein. A lack of fatty acids in the diet impairs glycolysis and acetyl coenzyme A metabolism. A lack of protein impairs pyruvate metabolism, acetyl coenzyme A metabolism, the citric acid cycle, and the urea cycle. These processes are crucial for energy metabolism as well as amino acid metabolism, ultimately determining energy capacity, muscle building, and recovery capability. A vegan will swear up and down that your body can make all of the amino acids it needs on a plant-based diet. And on paper, that might seem true. But the two main processes needed to synthesize amino acids becomes compromised when you are vegan. And these, unironically, are those same two processes important in muscle building that we mentioned earlier, the citric acid cycle and the urea cycle. The citric acid cycle is where our body synthesizes amino acids using pyruvate and acetyl coenzyme A. Your body needs proteins and fats to make acetyl coenzyme A. But as a vegan, you're depending on the citric acid cycle for certain proteins, and the diet is lacking in fats. So without question, the citric acid cycle is not working optimally. A waste product of amino acids is ammonia, which is highly toxic. That's why the urea cycle converts ammonia into urea, excreting it through the kidneys. The problem is that this urea cycle requires acetyl coenzyme A as well, and it requires glutamate, an amino acid contained mostly in animal foods. On top of that, plant-based proteins such as soy and wheat are more readily converted to urea when compared to animal-based proteins. But the urea cycle isn't only for removing ammonia. It is needed to recycle precursor molecules for the citric acid cycle, including amino acids. On top of this, a vegan diet is lacking in vitamin B12, vitamin B6, as well as folate, which results in high circulating homocysteine levels, another amino acid, putting even more stress on the urea cycle as well as the kidneys. These metabolic cycles are limited so much on a vegan diet, it becomes obvious why athletes can't even recover, let alone build muscle. And this isn't even going into the functions of acetyl coenzyme A. Every cell needs it to turn nutrients into energy, and lack of acetyl coenzyme A means lack of energy, which means lack of performance. It is needed for steroid synthesis, all of your hormones, and we know a male athlete with low testosterone is not going to fare well. It's needed for acetylcholine, which plays a vital role in our central nervous system as well as our peripheral nervous system, activating muscles and acting as a major neurotransmitter. Pretty easy to get injured if your muscles aren't firing properly. Acetylcoenzyme A is also needed for melatonin production, sleep hormone. An athlete that doesn't sleep well doesn't perform well. And that's not even half of it for acetylcoenzyme A. What explains this even better is when vegans use artificial means to enhance their performance. By taking steroids, you are removing the need for acetylcoenzyme A in steroid hormone production, also likely lowering the need of cholesterol in the body. It's arguable that taking testosterone on a vegan diet is the healthiest thing you can do because you're impairing your body's ability to produce testosterone on a plant-based diet. Same thing with vitamin B12 shots. You are taking massive amounts of stress off the urea cycle, off the methylation cycle when you are consuming exogenous B vitamin supplements, likely increasing overall muscle synthesis. But you will never see vegan athletes at the same level as others. If you were able to replicate the complete nutrient profile of an animal-based diet with all of the fat-soluble vitamins, cholesterol, minerals, fatty acids, then you would see vegan athletes performing at the same level. But we don't see that. What we actually see is quite the opposite. You have all of these vegan athletes claiming, oh, I went vegan, I feel so much better, I'm doing so much better. But that's not what is actually physically happening. Their performance is dropping, they're getting injured. Novak Djokovic, Serena Williams, any athlete that goes vegan is seeing a sharp decline in their performance, and they are getting injured very quickly because their body is not capable of repairing tissue, and then they are never able to recover from that injury. Thank you guys for joining me. If you could please like the video, subscribe, hit that bell icon, share the video if you can. If you guys would like to support me further, please go to frankiesfreerangemeat.com. High quality, nutrient-dense animal foods at an affordable price. We just had a really high quality local grass-fed cow brought in, and we're offering a 17-pound local beef box delivered to your door for less than $10 a pound. Limited quantity, guys. So again, frankiesfreerangemeat.com. Check that out. You can also go to Frankie's Naturals. Minimal ingredients, minimally processed hygiene and cosmetic products. Thanks again for joining me, guys, and enjoy the rest of your day.